Hello everyone, I am Meenal Zupe, Assistant Professor of Computer Engineering Department of All India Sri Shivaji Memorial Society's Institute of Information Technology, Pune.
So good morning all the students. Today we are seeing the code converters from one format to another format. Okay, so code converter means it takes the input code and it translates to the equivalent output code. So this may be the circuit for that, simple circuit for that. It input code, we are giving it to the code converter and then it will give you the output code. So examples of code converters are binary to gray code converter. Means here input is binary code and output is gray code. Okay. Similarly, there is gray to binary also. So input is gray code and output will be the binary code. Then we will see BCD to XS3 code converter. So here input is BCD code and output is XS3 code. So we will see one by one code converter and its digital circuit also. Okay. So first is binary to gray code converter. After that we'll see gray to binary. So first binary to gray. Here binary numbers, as all of we know that binary numbers, how to represent the binary numbers. So here we can say that this is the binary code B3, B2, B1 and B0. It is taken as 4-bit binary code B3, B2, B1 and B0. B3 is the MSB, B0 is the LSB. Most significant bit is B3, least significant bit is B0. Now we have to convert this binary code into the gray code. Okay, and again gray code is also in terms of 4 bits. Here G3 is my MSB bit, G0 is the LSB bit. So how to convert this binary code to gray code? So first step is record the most significant bit as it is. So as you see here, most significant bit is B3. We are recording that bit as it is to the gray code. So copy that bit B3 to G3. In the circuit also we can see that B3, B2, B1, B0 are the inputs. So in when we are converting to binary to gray, the MSB bit, that is B3, as it is as the MSB in a gray code. So this is the first, for the first bit. Then XOR this bit to the next position bit, record the resultant bit. Means the same bit, that is B3, we have to XOR this bit with the next binary bit, that is B2. So here these two bits are get XORed and the output will be my next gray code bit, that is G2. So similarly we have to do in the next bit also. So here it is XOR B3 and B2, that will be my G2. Then XOR B2 and B1, that will be the G1, that is output. And XOR B1, B0, and we will get G0 as the output. Okay, so here inputs are B3, B2, B1 and B0, and we will get G3, G2, G1 and G0 as the output. Okay, here also we can say that G3 and B3 bits are same. G2 is what? B3 XOR B2, G1 is B2 XOR B1, G0 is B1 XOR B0. And this is the circuit for converting from binary to gray code conversion. Okay, so this is the binary to gray. Okay, before seeing the gray to binary, we will see what is the use of gray code here. Why we have to convert this binary code to gray code? So what is the gray code system? So gray code system is binary number system. It is also a binary number system in which every successive pair of numbers differ in only one bit. Okay, we'll see that in the truth table, how it is. It is used in application in which the normal sequence of binary number generated by the hardware may produce an error or ambiguity during the transition from one number to the next number. Okay, for example, here it, we can take as, suppose binary numbers are 3 to 4. The one hardware system which may have the output as 3 to 4. The binary of 3 is 0, 1, 1 and 4 is 1, 0, 0. Okay, so in the sequence, suppose we are getting as output of that hardware system is 0, 1, 1, then 0, 0, 1, then 1, 0, 1 and 1, 0, 0. Okay, so see from 0, 1, 1 to 1, 0, 0, this will be the output. This, these are the in-between stages. So therefore, there is a high chance of wrong state being read while the system changes from the initial state to the final state. Okay, so this could have serious consequences for the machine using the information. But in gray code, what, how that gray code eliminates this problem, since there is only one bit changes, one bit difference its value during its transition between two numbers. Okay, so if you see here, my initial state is 0, 1, 1. When it transit to the next state, there will be two bits changes are there. See, here maybe it may be one, only this bit is get changing. Then, okay, from this to this, this to this, directly this is the initial state, this is the final state. So in initial state and the final state, there are two bits are changing. Okay, so this bit also change, then this bit also change, and this bit also change. Okay, so all bits are get changing, but in gray code system, there is only one bit change in the next sequence of the bits. How that we will see here. See, this is the binary input. We'll see. This is a truth table of binary numbers and gray code. Okay, so this is the input 0, 0, means this is the binary code and this is the gray code. Okay, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0, 0, 0, 0. For 0, 0, the gray code is same as binary. Okay, then 1. 1 is also same. Okay, see, now from this state to this state, you notice here only one bit is get changing from this state to this state. Again, if you consider this to this, so only this bit is get changing, only one bit is changing here. But in binary numbers, there is no such cases. Two or three bits are changing in the binary number if you take two consequent numbers. Okay, but in gray code, each and every state have only one bit change. See here, only this bit is change here, then this bit is change here, in this only this bit is change, now in this this bit is change. So here in gray code, this is the major advantage in the gray code. In each two state, only one bit is changing, so errors are less in a hardware system compared to the binary system. We will come to the gray to binary now. How we will convert from gray to binary. Okay, here it is same. See, the inputs are gray code and we will get the output as binary code, binary numbers. Okay, so the steps are, the gray code can be converted to binary by the reverse process as we have seen in binary to gray. So this is the gray code. 4 bits, G3, G2, G1 and G0. G3 is the MSB, G0 is the LSB. Okay, now here also G3 is copied as B3. So it is same. This all here in the diagram also we can see that G3 is same as B3. Okay, now to get the next binary bit B2, what we need to do, record the most significant, that was the first, then XOR binary MSB, means this binary, sorry, XOR binary MSB to the next bit of gray code. So next bit of gray code, here we can see C. G3 is gate XORed with the next G2. G3 is gate XORed with next G2 to get the binary number. Or I can do as B3 means the MSB of binary XOR with B3 is XOR with G2. Likewise, this XOR. Okay, so either way we can do it. G3 XOR with G2 or B3 XOR with G2, because here G3 and B3 are same in the first case. So we can do that. To get the B1, what we can do, we can now here it is XOR, we got the XOR of G3 and G2 as B2. Okay, so you can directly do XOR B2 with the G1, next bit of gray code. Or what else you can do, G3 XOR G2 or XOR G1. So all this XOR to get B1 bit. Then B0. So you can do all this XOR G3 XOR G2 XOR G1 XOR G0. Or what you can do, B1 XOR G0. And the same thing is written here also. Okay, to get all these binary numbers. So this is the circuit for converting gray to binary numbers. Now, so here we can see that by using the K-map, how we can get the minimized Boolean expression. For the gray code. Here it is a binary to gray conversion. Okay, so these are the binary numbers, these are the gray code numbers. Now, to get G0, see, this is the K map. Here inputs are what? B0, B1, B2 and B3 means our binary numbers. All the inputs are binary numbers. But to get the, what you can say, Boolean expression for G0, in the K map we have to enter this G0 column. G0 column we have to enter for these binary numbers as an input. So here we can see for 0000, what is G0? 0. So here it is entered as 0. Then for the next binary input 0001, the G0 is 1. So here it is entered at 0000, G0 is 1. Then one of the entry I am checking now, see, suppose 1011, for this input what is G00? So 1011, this is 10110, what we are seeing, 1000, so this G0 is 0. So likewise for G0 we have to enter all the whole G0 column. Okay, and then we can find out the grouping. So this is the first group and this may be the second group. Okay, so for this group, what is the equation? It is B1 bar B0 and this, for this group, it is B1 B0 bar. Okay, so this is the equation and that is nothing but our XOR truth table. So it is B0 XOR B1, B0 XOR B1. So similarly G1, for getting minimized Boolean expression for G1, we entered G1 column in this K map and we will get this grouping. Okay, so this is my first group, this is the first group and this is the second group. Okay, for that I'll get the equation as B2 b1 bar plus b1 b2 bar, and which is nothing but what? b1 xor b2. Okay, similarly for g2, we'll get b2 xor b3 as Boolean equation, and for g3, this is only the group I can form in the k-map, so for that I'll get only b3 as the equation. Okay, so g3 equal to b3. So for g0, g1, g2 and g3, these are the Boolean equation, and this is what we can draw in terms of digital circuit. So by using these equations, I can draw the digital circuit for binary to gray code converter. So inputs are what? B3, B2, B1, B0. Okay, to get the output, so G3 is nothing but what? See the G3 and B3, G3 equation, it is B3 only. So directly we can get this. Okay, now for G2, getting G2, what I need to do? B2 XOR B3. So getting G2, I have to give B3 and B2 as input to this XOR gate, and I'll get G2 as the output. Okay, similarly for getting G1, so G1's equation is what? B1 XOR B2. So B1 XOR B2 will be the G1. And G0, equation of G0 is B0 XOR B1. So B0 XOR B1. I'll get the equation for G0. So this is the conversion from binary to gray. Similarly, we can do the conversion for gray to binary by drawing the truth table and by drawing the k-maps and getting the minimize equations for gray to binary, and then we will have this kind of digital circuit there. Okay, thank you. Okay, so